I'm Natalia Bonner. It's day 319. Today we're going to be stitching using my mini 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler. Let's get stitching! I'll start out by using my mini 4-in-1 machine quilting ruler and stitching in the ditch all the way around the outside of my triangle quilt block. From there, I'm going to begin stitching a straight line, moving in a half inch from the outside of my block. So to do that, I'm going to travel in so that the first marked line on my machine quilting ruler intersects the outside of my block. Then after that, I'll travel across the ditch again, moving over a quarter of an inch, stitching that second line. After I've stitched that line, then I'm going to adjust and I'm going to stitch my next line at the 1-inch mark. So to stitch the 1-inch mark, I'm going to adjust my ruler so that the 1-inch marking on the machine quilting ruler is right on top of that stitch line. This is an easy way to do it without adding a lot of extra markings to your quilt. So I'll stitch a line at the 1-inch increment. From there, then I'll adjust my ruler again, traveling across the ditch, moving over a quarter of an inch. Now for the next set of lines, I'm going to again adjust my ruler, but this time moving over just a half an inch. So that half inch marking will be on top of my previous stitch line. Then I'm going to repeat this again, doing another set, but this time the lines will be again 1 inch apart. I'll complete this design by adding one more single line that's a half inch from the previous line. Now, once I've stitched those, I'm going to go through and start filling in those smaller spaces with some fun back and forth straight line matchstick quilting. So the first space that you can see that I'm filling in here with those matchstick lines is the half inch space that's on the outside of the triangle block. Once I've stitched that first set, I'll skip the 1 inch space, travel over to the next half inch space, and I'll fill that one in again with those fun back and forth matchstick lines. So a fun way to really add a lot of texture and dimension to a quilt. I hope you enjoyed today's block and found a little bit of inspiration with my machine quilting. Now just remember, you can pick up the panel, the rulers, the thread, all of the notions that I'm using in this video today over on my website, peaceandquilt.com. And don't forget to share your progress pictures over on Instagram using the hashtag #LetsStitchWithNatalia. That's where we will be selecting winners for weekly prizes. See you all tomorrow!